start with telling you a little bit about myself. Growing up, I didn't believe that there was a standard of beauty. And as I started to grow up, I realized that wasn't the case. I remember coming home from school and turning on the TV to watch maybe my novelas or maybe whatever music was playing on TV shows. But one of the things I was looking forward to is to watch America's Next Top Model. And you would think that as a child, being 10 or 11 years old, I would be watching cartoons, but that wasn't the case. In my head, I believed that I was gonna be like them one day. That I was gonna be the most famous American model in the world. And my heart told me otherwise. I knew that I was not gonna be like them because I would not fit their mold. And now, we see girls, 10, 11 years old, going every day to the mall and picking up one of these bags. But how much do you think they're spending? $10, $20? Believe it or not, they spend more than $43 on average. But differently, we see here in a chart that cosmetics is about one in every two women spend more than $150. And globally, that adds up. One will see that about $382 billion is spent on, while only in the US is $62 billion. So what created these standards? Well, first, I will explain this thoroughly, but precision through words, the idea of beauty is pain and passed down from generation to generation, and the eternal youth belief. I read a novel by Mark Tungay called Branded Beauty and How Marketing Changed the Way We Looked. And one of the interesting quotes he stated is, if Marie Antoinette was considered an icon of fashion, and she lived now, as you see, her future would have been altered to conform to an impossible ideal. That means that her beauty back then will no longer be considered the beauty now. Perception through words created a standard beauty ideal. These words that we see up here as enhanced, scientific, anti-aging are words that are commonly used in products, not only in advertising, but in their packaging as well. And Tungay explains to us that it's the oldest tactic that beauty brands use to consumers to be paranoid about their looks, which means they use our own fear of not being beautiful enough to sell us products. However, the American Medical Association adopted a policy against false advertising, which included on how they wanted to not use words that will mislead the consumer, but also alteration of images to create unrealistic expectations. These are some of the cosmetic companies that are major, which we only think of makeup as being the dominant, but we also do have skincare, haircare, fragrances, and personal care. On the right, we see that these are the top 10 companies in the United States that have relevance to how we buy products. So over time, we see that beauty has changed. In the early time of civilization, we had one prominent goddess, Aphrodite. We believe that she is the ideal beauty in the world, even though we had no idea how she really looked like. We created that standard, and as time changed, as we became more involved in entertainment, that also changed. As we can see in 1915, Marilyn Monroe was considered the most beautiful woman of our time. Yet, as time went over, we see women like Angelina Jolie become more beautiful, the standard of beauty. So let's look at some advertisements. Back then, we didn't have color. We have minimum color, but we use certain descriptive words that will appeal to women to get their attention, to create a statement. Now, we still use those same words. However, we try to build women's confidence by using words such as fearless and exclusive to being unique to their time. As I referred, entertainment does have an influence on how we see ourselves. And celebrities play a big role. We do have good ones and bad. I'm not saying that they're all bad. What I'm saying is we have the latest one as being Rihanna, who came out with her product, Fenty Beauty. But she believed she wanted women to feel beautiful. She wanted women to feel comfortable in their skin. She says, so that women will be everywhere, will be included to feeling beautiful. But then we do have a battle where we have Kylie Cosmetics. Cosmetics' purpose is not about enriching a woman's beauty to a degree, but to create and help a woman create that beauty, perfect Kylie look. She's a fashion trendsetter. So obviously there's young girls looking up to her, believing that that's how we're supposed to look like. And then we have famous celebrities like Megan Fox, who is just part of a model, is just a model. She does not take in part of what the product is truly about. So, but when we see them, we see no imperfections. They look younger than what they really are. And let's take a moment to look at this woman. She's beautiful, right? You don't see no imperfections, clear skin. And this is the woman we see in magazines. This is the woman we think is beautiful. This is the woman that our children are gonna see. However, we have another one. You see, this is how she really looks like. These are her imperfections. And CVS Pharmacy is trying to change that. They want to go from the woman on the left to the woman on the right by the end of 2020. By stop using altering pictures in their stores. Because going as back to the American Medical Association, we need to stop false on advertising. But how are women portrayed? Let's look at this magazine cover. We see the one on the left, it's an English advertisement, while the one on the right, it's a Spanish advertisement. Do you guys notice the difference? It's the same product. But the woman on the one in Spanish, it's a lighter skinned woman. This is something that is built, that is seen throughout many years, that we are told that we need to look lighter skinned, and that is not always a positive mindset. While the one on the left is a dark skin, and that's because we're trying to make women in our culture feel accepted by their skin color. Looking at this chart, we see that the majority of spending by consumers on cosmetics, at least once a month, is mostly color skin women. They are the biggest allies to these companies. But why is that? In Latino communities, there's the standard that we need to really fit into the mold, that we always have to adapt to society. But that's what creates a low self-esteem in women. I remember growing up, my mom told me, I need to look different to be accepted. And I think that affected the way I looked at myself. Though I do say that media does play a huge part in cosmetic industry, it also starts at home. We are influenced by our parents since a young age, and we try to spend our time altering ourselves. Dove demonstrated this video where daughters and mothers described what they liked about themselves and what they also disliked about them. And watching this video made me realize how much my mom influenced on me, because the things that the daughters disliked about themselves is also something they had gained from seeing what their mother said about themselves. They said that if one of them did not like their eyes, the daughter didn't like her eyes either. And a surprisingly statistic fact that I found out is that girls between the ages of 18 to 24 are more likely to get plastic surgery and are probably more encouraged by their parents to continue to do throughout their lifetime. So, can we end an industry? No, it's not humanly possible, because no matter what, we always gonna find a way to believe that we have imperfections. But companies that are trying to make women feel more confident, such as Dove, who makes their mission to ensure that the next generation is growing up enjoying a positive relationship with the way they look, helping girls to raise their self-esteem and realize their full potential, is what we need to start changing. Our mindset, that is one of the solutions we can start doing. Because if we give women the empowerment of feeling confident, not by their looks, but by their leadership, by their pride in their achievements, and this could change the way that we let control that bag no longer be affected in our younger generations. Thank you. Any questions?
Okay. When Elizabeth Taylor was the face for, who was it, Max?
Elizabeth Taylor created her own line.
She created, okay, I thought it said creative line. Do you know what the most popular selling lipstick was, since they were putting out those buzzwords to get women to
continue? So, if I remember my research, each company created their own line, so they always try to like bite off information of the competitors. So they try to use what they knew to get the attention of the woman at the time. So I think it was mostly how they promoted it as well, because the more they tried different things, like sending things at home or like letting them try it out at their stores, kind of thing.
So we talked about the Dove move, and that was a big splash when Dove announced that they would not be editing photos anymore in their advertisements and in their product packaging. And I was hopeful that more companies would follow suit, but I haven't seen any. Have you heard of any in your research?
No, I was looking for that information, and there's not many companies. But like I did say, it's a lot about who we're looking up to. So if now we're able to access this in videos on YouTube by celebrities, by girls around the country or the world who are trying to promote self-beauty, but also using these products. So if we can't change a mindset from day to night, but hopefully, but eventually we're able to not always use these products to build confidence, but to demonstrate a little bit of our uniqueness instead.
You said that CVS was going to start a campaign of non-photoshopping?
Yes.
When do you know when?
Oh, I said Dove, and I know.
Yeah, CVS. They're starting, but by 2020, they want to have their stores completely remove those type of products.
Are they like inspiring any other companies to
not that
stop
I found
photoshopping?
No.
Yeah, that's what I was asking. But now that I misspoke, I said Dove. But what it reminds me is that Dove actually was a leader in this.
Dove is one number one leaders in this. And I think maybe as if Dove continues to influence other companies, then it could start to change.
So that's helped through CVS. And I don't know about you guys, I'm a huge Target shopper.
Yeah.
I am seeing a difference in the
we didn't have all this computer media. Like, when I was a kid, there was no,
no.
You were either maybe the chunky kid or the skinny kid, but that's about it. But as my child was growing up, she's being influenced by all of this crazy beauty gurus and stuff. So companies that stop promoting that stuff, I'd rather spend my dollars there.
Yeah, like I mentioned, my mom isn't the type of woman who decides to wear, she jokes around there, pounds of makeup. And that's why I rarely use makeup, because I don't know. Like, if you ask me what's the difference between contour and highlighter, I'll be like, I don't know, they just go on my face, probably.
Yeah.
So